The shoulders up and down a few times. Just release out the working day. Okay, and then just begin to settle yourself down. Feel that your sit bones are evenly placed beneath you. And just allow your rib cage to just gently draw down into your body. And just shutting your eyes, going inside, deep breath. In. Breathing all the way back out. Take a long deep breath in. Breathing all the way back out. Deep breath in. And out. This time, take a longer, deeper breath in. And then drawing down with your chin and holding onto your breath. And raising your chin back up and breathing all the way back out again. Take a long, deep breath in. Lowering down your chin and holding onto your breath. And raising your chin back up and breathing all the way back out again. Taking a longer, deeper breath in, really fill up the lung space. And now breathe all of the way back out and go right down to the bottom of your exhalation. Lower down your chin and holding your breath out. And let's raise the chin back up, breathing in. One more time, breathing out. Again, breathing out as completely as you can. Just go right down to the bottom of your exhalation and try and breathe out a little bit more. Lower down the chin and holding the breath out. Raising your chin back up and breathing in. Breathing out. Long deep breath in. Breathing all the way back out. And then if we can clasp our fingers, raising arms high above your head. Take a deep breath in, and as you breathe out, taking a little rotation with your upper body. Breathing and bring it to the middle. Breathing out a little rotation with your upper body. Breathing and back to the middle. Breathing out, lower down our hands, and carefully lift up upon the knees. Untangle your heels and sit right back upon them. Lifting your chin, let's gently draw your body along the ground, rolling down the shoulders and lifting the chin up. Curling with your toes and sending the hips back and drawing the head down through your arms. Come on forwards into a high plank and then bending with your knees and sitting back to your heels. Breathing in as you roll the body up and through. Breathing out, sending the hips back. Let your head fall down through your arms. Breathing in, draw forwards to a high plank. Breathing out, bending your knees and releasing, sitting back. Breathing in as you roll the body up. Breathing out as you lengthen backwards, head down, bottom up. Breathing in, draw forwards to plank. Breathing out, bending knees, sitting back. brush the arm forwards, big shoulder stretch open as you go back. Again, breathing in through it forwards, all the way back. One more time. This time, let's wrap the arm all the way back behind the body, looking back over your shoulder, tucking your tailbone under, nice long neck. Take a couple deep breaths. Then gently bring the body round. Take your hand to the floor. Go up onto the toes on the back leg and raise the left arm. Go a little bit deeper into that front knee if you can. Deep breath in through the nose, out through your nose. And bring your hand down. Set the feet together behind you. And I'd like to draw slowly down upon your forearms, if you can, both at the same time. Now looking slightly beyond your fingers, you've got your knees up off the ground in your forearm plank. Let's have 10 breaths here. Breathing in, breathing out. Let's really start to get into the core strength here. In, out, belly pulls back. Looking beyond your fingers. Pull up on your bottom rib. Breathe in and out, four. In, out, five. In, out, six. In, out, seven. In, out, eight. In, out, nine. And in, out, ten. Lower yourself gently back down upon the floor. Now let's just bring the arms down by your side. Let's work into the breaststroke here. So if you turn the feet slightly in and let your shoulders drop upon the floor. As you breathe in, let's roll back the shoulders and open the chest. As you breathe out, let's pull back through the core, raise and hover, keep your legs relaxed upon the floor if you can. Breathing in, and breathing out, let's lower the shoulders back. Breathing in as we roll back and down with your shoulders, breathing out to engage the core, and if you can, opening the palms away from you. Breathing in, and breathing out, let's roll the shoulders back and down. Breathing and rolling back open with your chest. Breathing out, draw the navel back to the spine as you lift. Breathing in to stay. And breathing out to lower all the way back. Breathing in, shoulders rolling back and down. Breathing out to engage the core as you lift. Breathing in, stay. And breathing out as we lower. One more time. Breathing in, roll back the shoulders. Use the core as you lift to hover. Breathing in to stay. And breathing out as you lower. And then planting your hands beneath your shoulders. Feet a little bit wider now, drawing into a gentle upward facing dog. Just relaxing your shoulders again. Seeing where we're getting to with that curve of your lumbar spine. Gently lower back down. Just come up onto your knees for me. And this is coming to thread the needle as a stretch. So I'm going to draw the right arm beneath. And I'm going to option for you that you also take the right leg out to the side for an inner thigh stretch. If you don't fancy it today, just do the shoulder bit, okay? But if you are going to use the leg, I would encourage you to put the leg out first, okay? It's a little bit tricky the other way around. So take the right arm underneath and off, and if you can, the right leg out goes out to the side. And then you put your ear down on the ground. But if you get there and you think, maybe not all of this today, come back on up and just regroup. And let's just do the shoulder part. So in the shoulder bit, we should get a stretch over your shoulder, a little bit of a stretch release into the lower back. Obviously, you've got the leg out and you've got the inner thigh stretching. Gently draw your body up and go the other way. So if you're doing the leg two, get the leg out first, and then take your arm beneath and lower your ear down on the ground. And just again, take a couple of deep breaths here. In through your nose, out through your nose. heel down, we're facing dog. Then step forwards with your right foot, releasing your knee down into the ground. And then step forwards with your left foot and fold. Take a deep breath in, coming all the way back out to standing. Breathing out, hands back to your heart. Breathing and raising both arms. Breathing out, diving your body forwards. Breathing and left leg steps back and let's place it onto the floor again. Heel flat down. Let's draw up the right elbow to the right knee. And take a couple of circles here. Breathing and brush the ground. Breathing out, fold the hand back. And again, breathing and brush the ground. Big circle back, opening. Using those chest muscles, pectoral muscles, breathing out, opening your back. One more time, breathing in, opening it all the way back, look back behind you. Just take a couple of breaths there, in through your nose, out through your nose. And then we'll turn the body around. Hand out to the floor, go to the toes on the back leg, raise your right arm, look it up. And now bring the hand to the outside of your foot, slide your feet together. I'd like you to just again come down upon your knees. This time we're going to work up into dolphin. So I'd like to clasp your fingers together. Now we want to know that our hands would reach around the ends of our elbows when we make that position, that V-shaped position. We want to try and keep that the same. Now starting on the knees, breathe out through your mouth and draw the navel back to the spine as you move your weight forwards, and then breathing in to draw back. Breathing out and engaging the core as you come forwards. Breathing into your back. If you feel strong enough to take it up into your toes, straighten your legs. Breathing out as you come forwards and into your back. Breathing out, engaging the core coming forwards. Breathing into your back. We should be able to feel a little bit of strength work coming around the upper back. Hopefully, when you bring that body forwards, you can feel that automatic lift up into the core. Okay, again, same as with the plank. As you come forwards, try not to dip your lower back. Keep your body very board-like. Two more if you can. Breathing out, looking beyond your fingers. Breathing and drawing back. One more time. Breathing out, looking beyond. And then let's gently draw your knees down. Okay, now if you can place your right arm to come across your mat, feet about as wide as your mat behind, deep breath in. And as you breathe out, coming up into our turn on cobra, looking over the shoulder, trying to keep the hips on the floor if you can, trying to keep the lower part of the body just completely out of the twist. And bring it back on down, we go the other way. Arm coming across, fingertips down to the floor, deep breath in, coming on up. And breathing out, looking over your shoulder. Again, just relaxing from the waist and downwards. And bring it all the way back. Hands beneath your shoulders, gently draw it up into your upward dog without any force. Just again, resting into it. Deep breath in. Let's breathe out lower. Curling your toes, engaging your core. Breathe in, push up to plank. Breathe out to a downward facing dog. Breathing in, left foot stepping through. Lifting the chin and releasing the toes back. Breathing out, right leg stepping through and folding. Breathing in, pull out through the belly, open the shoulders, the chest, kiss your thumbs. Breathing out, hands to your heart. Breathing in, let's raise both arms. Breathing out and dive your body forwards. Breathing in, I'm stepping back with your left leg, leaving your right leg at the top. Let your left knee, right knee, sorry, come down into towards your armpit. come up and let's do a couple of shoulder rolls just to release the neck and around the upper back. So I want to bring the shoulders to draw back and the chest to open a bit more. Turn the palms up. When you bring your arms up, bring the arms kind of from the back to come up and then look up either between your hands or to your thumbs. Only when we get there, drop your ribs down into your body. Now again, that's very much going to be an intentional thought and movement, okay? You want to really try and melt down the bottom rib so that, you know, the bottom end of your body is not flaring. Take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, warrior two. So again, little tuck under with the tailbone, rolling the knees open, lightly gazing along the center of your right hand. Alright, but really pulling back with the left, feeling a lovely balance between both of your feet. Take a deep breath in, and as you breathe out, reverse, looking out towards your upper hand. Perhaps here we could straighten the leg, and maybe balance on the heel, but again, don't worry, you don't want to go there today, you don't have to.
Want to
reach back or take the back of your legs, whatever needs to do. So taking a deep breath in. As you breathe out, opening the chest. And reaching along for the back of your legs or reaching for your heels.
Sort of burrow the knee Holding the shoulders and the chest open back, raising your arms up. Either look between your hands or look towards your thumbs. Just feel a nice, equal balance between both of your feet. So in particular, if you feel that your front loading too much, take some weight backwards. Deep breath in. Breathe out into warrior two. Rolling back the shoulders, opening the knees. Coming a little bit deeper into the front knee. Deep breath in. As you breathe out, reaching back, looking up. If you can, straighten the front leg, balance up onto your heel. And then cartwheel the hands all the way back down to the ground. Turn your back knee and placing it in towards the floor. Both your hands on the inside of your foot and just gently easing down. Coming down into a lizard posture, just opening up the hip, working into the top of your hamstrings. To go a little bit further, work your left hand underneath your left leg, go down to the edge of your foot and ease the body down. Taking your left leg high. back towards the ceiling into a down dog split. And then drawing your left knee towards your elbow. Now drawing your left foot towards your right hand. Backing down to the floor, raising your right arm up. Coming up out here into your forearm triangle. Feel the oblique muscles working. Shoulder support here, the underarm. Now let's take the hand down to the ground, bring your left knee towards your left wrist. Alright, so again, if you took your forehead down towards the floor last time, maybe do that again, balance the body up. If you're looking to bring the back leg up from the ground, just again, watch that it's not wandering up too much. You want to feel that your thigh is resting on the floor. And if you can, you want to feel that you're taking the shoulders so that they are level. So we don't want to eventually twist too far backwards. You may be twisting a little, maybe in turning a little, if you're in transition. All right, but if you're static holding, again, you want to try and keep everything nice and strong. Let leg go, hands down towards the floor, curl the toes and push back off into your down dog. Okay, let's take a nice big stride through the left leg, dropping your right knee halfway down your mat. Let's take a deep breath in, raise the right arm, and as you come across, either hands in prayer, or maybe you're taking the hand to the floor, having called the armpit over the top of your knee. And then maybe we lean forwards, lift up the back knee perhaps, or maybe bring the left arm over. Okay, now let the arms out. If you haven't already put your back foot flat to the floor, coming into humble warrior, clasping your fingers to the back, and then your head drop down, looking towards your back foot. Then bring the body back on up. Hands either side of your foot, turn the back foot, lightly step your feet up together. Take a nice deep breath in, coming all the way back out to standing. Breathing out, hands back in towards your heart. Okay, now coming into a couple of balances. Let's start off with your tree. So let's open up with your shoulders, spread out your toes, and put energy up into your thighs. And then start to lift up your right foot, place it either to your calf or above your knee. Heart, encouraging the knee to press backwards if you can. Slowly bring the fingers up through the midline of your body. Maybe take your right hand back behind your neck. Chin lifts a little. And then let's let both of your arms down, but bending your left knee a little. And taking your right leg to hook around. Coming into eagle. Bring your left arm across. And take your right arm beneath. Alright, now we're still okay. Maybe draw your body gently forwards. Elbow coming towards your knee. Carefully coming back up. And if you can, either picking up your right leg from underneath or extending it straighter or taking your first two fingers around your right big toe. Just to give a little stretch out there to the leg. Shoulders drawn back, belly pulled in. Can let go, hold that leg in the same position, breathe. up with the left leg, placing it above or below the knee. Hands in your heart, and then slowly, if you can, bring the hands up through the midline of your body. Left hand going back behind your right. Chin lifts.
Taking you down on the last one to remain. I'm just
going to swing myself around whilst I get there so that I can still see what you're doing. Okay. So very slowly, if you need to, you could also do the same thing. You're rolling back. I'm just going to swing around so you can see what I'm doing from the side. So I'm going to take the right leg up towards the ceiling. And if you can, keep the leg a little bit straighter, but your hamstrings are super tight today, bend them. I'm going to take my right hand behind my right leg and lift the left leg up, but support my head with my left hand. Then from here, left leg comes up, breathe in, and then the left leg goes straight down. We're not swapping legs, we're staying on that leg. Breathing in, breathing out, engage the core as you lower. Chin is up off your chest, your distance of the fist underneath your chin and chest. Breathe in, bring the leg up. Breathing out, lower it straight back. Not quite touching the floor when it goes down. Just a little hover. Two more there if you can. Breathing in, breathing out. One more time. In and out. All right. Let your right leg down. Let's regroup. Bring up the left leg. Holding the left leg very gently behind the knee. Raising your head, neck and shoulders, supporting your head with your right hand, hovering your right leg an inch off the floor. Breathing in, raising your right leg up, breathing out as you lower. Again, nice open elbow. Okay, you've got a really strong connection through your core. You may be bending your knee if you feel your lower back is being compromised, if your lower back is trying to push too hard against the floor. Just bend the knee a little. Try not to hold onto your leg too hard. Try to feel that you're holding yourself up there using your core energy. Breathing in, breathing out to lower. Breathing in, breathing out to lower. Again, breathe in, out as you lower. Two more there. Breathe in, out to lower. One more time. And out as you lower. Okay, lowering down left leg too. Okay, I'm going to come up into our shoulder bridge. So if you could draw your heels in, and just about have them on touching distance with your fingertips. Take a deep breath in. And as you breathe out, now deliberately imprint the spine, peel the back away from the floor, energizing the thigh muscles, so send energy up through towards your knees. Breathing at the top, and then breathing out to lower your back. I'm going to try not to clench the buttocks too much. Deep breath in, breathing out, engaging the core. Draw the hips away from the floor, send energy up into your thighs. Breathing in. And then breathing out as you slowly recognize the movement of your back down against the floor. Breathing in, breathing out to ripple through your spine, come on up onto your shoulders. Breathing in, breathing out as you know. Now, this is a great therapy to you today. You don't want to move it on, absolutely do a few more just like that. Or next time you come up, breathing out, lifting. When you get to the top, make sure the glutes are switched down. And then come to an alternating hip lift. Breathing out to let one hip bone come slightly higher. Breathe in to lower. Breathing out, let the other hip bone come slightly higher. Breathe in to lower. Now this one is not a massive movement. The hardest bit is trying to quieten down the usage of the glutes, because they really do want to just take over. But we want to try and find the internal oblique strength coupled in with your transverse abdominal strength. So the deep core center of your body becomes responsible for that subtle movement. Breathing out as you lift into lower. Breathing out, lift into lower. And again, breathing out, find the core, into lower. And lower. And breathing out, lift. And lower, two more. And lower. And take a breath in. Lower your back carefully down into the floor. Now, last little exercise I'm going to use here. I'm going to place the hands so they are flat down on the floor, either side of you. I'm going to bring the knees together, bring the feet up onto their tiptoes. And then as you gently let your knees roll to one side, breathing out, and breathing in to come back up. Breathing out, let the knees roll the other way, and breathing in. So I want to keep the shoulder blades and the palms flat against the floor. And as you let your knees roll from one side to the other, become aware of the oblique muscles, your waist, and also become aware of the lower back stretch. Now this is plenty. If it already feels like you're doing a lot with your body, carry on. You don't need to take it any further. If you want to go harder in, pick up the feet, have the feet lining up with your knees. Bring the knees away from the body so they're not over the body, but they line up with your hips. And from there, breathing out to take the knees over, breathing in to draw back. But resist the temptation to crush. Okay, don't crush the knees all the way down. You want to keep the tension on there. Okay, like I say, make sure it's the abdominal strength usage coming in. You want to keep those shoulder blades fixed down upon the floor. Breathing out to take the knees across. Breathing in. Finishing off your last one. And then we can gently let ourselves roll over to one side. Press your body back on up to seated. And let's come back to where we started. Now, if you have a half lotus that you'd like to work with today, shift up your right foot first and just place it to the top of your left thigh. We're going to use the left leg underneath to support. And from here, taking across your left arm, letting your right hand come behind. So you can either hold onto your big toe or you could just use the left hand to help you turn. Shoulder.